My name is Nessan Bermingham. I'm the founder, president, and CEO of Triplet Therapeutics.
My name is Brian Bettencourt, and I'm the senior vice president of research at Triplet.
My name is Irina Antonijevic, and I'm the chief medical officer at Triplet Therapeutics.
So I'm Anne Rosser. I'm professor of clinical neuroscience at Cardiff University. And I'm the current chair of the European Huntington's Disease Network, which is also known as EHDN.
Triplet was founded back in 2018, really to pursue drugging genetic modifiers of repeat expansion disorders.
Our focus at Triplet and our mission is to treat unmet medical needs, and specifically treat Huntington's disease as our first indication, moving or expanding into additional repeat expansion disorder indications such as myotonic dystrophy. Others that many of you may be aware of are things like spinal cerebellar ataxia, Friedreich's ataxia, DRPLA, and many others. When we think about diseases such as Huntington's disease, well, it's been very clear around the repeat that's present within the HTT gene. And yet, as we think about the therapeutic approach for it, it really is understanding how best to actually treat that disease. What we've known from a lot of work that's been done is that you can take two individuals that are born with exactly the same number of repeats, but when you actually look at their age of onset and progression of the disease, they can actually significantly differ by even up to 40 years. So the question has been, that's been raised is, well, why is that the case? And what is the driver, or what is causing this difference in age of onset and progression of the disease, even though the underlying genetic change is exactly the same?
There was a lot of really exciting work that came out more recently, so in the past 5 to 10 years, say, it's not necessarily the length of the repeat that you're born with that is the main driver of when you'll get onset of the disorder and how fast it'll progress. It's actually the continued expansion of these repeats in cells in your body in disease-affected tissues. So for example, in the brain for Huntington's, they continue to grow. And it's that expansion that in turn drives the involvement of a pathway, right? So a collection of proteins called the DNA damage response pathway. So what we set out to do then was to drug some of these genetic modifiers in the DDR pathway that, you know, they're involved in really important aspects of DNA damage response and repair. But in the case of short DNA repeat expansion disorders, their involvement can be a bad thing in that it's required for those repeats to continue to expand in the disease-affected tissues. So the neat thing is that, you know, our research and the research of others in the field has indicated that you can knock down or inhibit particular members of the DDR pathway and stop the expansion of the disease-causing repeats in those disease-affected tissues. But you do not negatively impact other important aspects of DNA damage response, which is really key for safety, right?
Shield-HD is a study that we launched in last year, and it is meant to give us relevant information on the natural course of the disease in both pre-manifest patients but also early manifest patients with HD.
So the purpose of SHIELD is to work out how well a specific range of tests perform in tracking change in Huntington's disease. So these tests include measures of molecules in blood and cerebrospinal fluid, as well as clinical measures of change in individuals with Huntington's. So understanding these measures properly will be important for Triplet in order to plan the treatment trial, which will need to use these measures to track whether the treatment is getting to the right place and whether it's effective or not. So in other words, SHIELD-HD is laying the pathway for a future treatment trial.
we are very committed to hear from patients. Now that we have started to plan the start of our phase one clinical trial, we have already conducted patient advisory boards where we invite a small group of patients and we discuss Triplet's therapeutic approach, and we listen to the questions, also the concerns from patients, and we want to work with them to hopefully design a clinical trial protocol that is acceptable and of interest to patients, but also meets, of course, the goal of helping us develop a new drug.
The success of Triplet is absolutely dependent on our patients and our patients' willingness to work with us, for example, through the natural history study, in addition to the clinical studies that we will be running or we expect to run. Now, as we think about that, we have, as a company, a moral obligation to you. As we think about moving this company forward and thinking not only about the development and commercialization of our drugs, but it's also ensuring that we're able to make these drugs in a fashion that's affordable to you and that you will have access to.
Thank you.